On the subject of ratings, the post-WrestleMania Raw, the post-WrestleMania NXT with their move to Tuesday, both did very well. SmackDown was slightly down. And then we go back to Raw this week, and Raw did better than I expected, that's for sure.
Yeah, Raw did well. By the way,
NXT was up as well.
NXT was up a little bit, yeah, from last week. They were up a little bit. The thing that I thought was most interesting is that, do you realize that the last 2 years has been an illusion and never happened?
I was completely unaware. I would like the last at least year to have been an illusion happened, but...
Only in wrestling. The rest of the world was actually not an illusion, only wrestling.
Well, what happened?
Paul Levesque explained that, in fact, what was his wording? That was
the imaginary war.
The imaginary war. It was all our imagination.
You know, I like this guy, but sometimes he says stuff and I'm just like, dude, I can't take you seriously. Like, you're going to tell me with a straight face that there was no competition, there was no...
Well, they always did.
Like, every time AEW announced a big show, you immediately counter-program. So how can you, with a straight face, tell me that this was an imaginary war?
Well, especially...
Like, that takes some balls.
Especially because of everything that happened in 2019, everything that happened in 2019, there's actually stuff in 1989 too, but that's a different war. But you have to remember that in the 80s, when they were at war with Jim Crockett Promotions, they always claimed that they're not our competition. Our competition is, you know, whatever, you know, the NBA or whatever. They would never claim that they were in competition with wrestling companies. Our competition was with other things. The only time they've ever acknowledged being in a wrestling war was the one that they won. Although I guess they won the one with Crockett, which was the WCW one. But this one, they're obviously not going to, you know, acknowledge that one because of what happened. So, I mean, but the whole thing is like they got on TV specifically to run AEW out. I mean, there's that was what it was all about. It was to make sure that AEW didn't succeed. That's why they signed every one of those big contracts when guys' contracts were up. You know, everything that happened was about that. I mean, not everything that happened was about that, but everything was, you know, that was the key stuff as far as, you know, getting on USA and everything like that. The time slot was identical. They got the 2 week jump. They rushed on the air. You remember how they rushed on the air so they could get the 2 week jump, which in hindsight ended up backfiring because they were already 2 weeks in and had already shown their hand when AEW started. So AEW started with that giant number. If they had both started on the same night, AEW would not have started with that giant number because they both would have had that. They would have been dividing the audience. By week three, people had seen AEW and NXT, and they wanted to see AEW. And then, you know, for the next, 18 months, you know, they had the war. And the results are what the results were. And it was, in fact, all an illusion. It was all made up.
And then he goes on about, oh, I'm so excited to be on Tuesdays. Tuesdays is so great. There's so many things we can do. And I'm like, well, why weren't you on Tuesdays then?
Especially, look.
I mean,
look,
if it wasn't a competition and Tuesdays are better, then what the hell are we doing on Wednesdays?
Well, obviously, you know why.
Well, I know why, but in his imagination, what he's telling us, if you're telling us there was no competition and it's better to be on Tuesdays, then what is his explanation for why they were on Wednesdays for a year and a half, 2 years?
A year and a half.
Because that doesn't make any sense.
Well, especially because anyone with a smidgen of a brain knew that they would draw better on Tuesdays. So they spent a year and a half sacrificing 150 to 200,000 viewers a week, you know, because it was more important to them to sacrifice, you know, a large percentage of their audience to keep the other company from garnering a bigger audience. And now I think that they're probably sitting there going like, you know, especially, you know, based on last week, it's like, fuck, now what do we do? Because it's what happened is like, you know, a lot worse than anybody thought it would be, you know, when it came to AEW without competition, whether that will stay that way. I guess tomorrow is actually like the most important rating for anything in God knows how long, because it's actually like an indication of where AEW will be.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts. And also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.